tag number 71 from class 103. I need exhibitor 205, Triston Boehning, tag number 73. And from tag 104, class 104, I need exhibitor 205, Triston Boehning, tag number 88. I think we have four really nice efforts here in this champion drive. Let's give these kids a round of applause. Okay, I talked about each one of these efforts in their classes, and these are your four class winners that came out here now. And there again, I think we got, you know, a really nice group of heifers. At this time, I will go congratulate your champion, reserve champion, and honorable mention, in my opinion, in that order. So I don't have them in particular order right out here right now, but at this time I'll go out there and select your champion reserve and then honorable mention. Champion heifer goes to exhibitor 205, Triston Boehning, and the reserve champion goes to exhibitor.
Waggoner number 205, also Triston Pony. Honorable mention goes to the shortest guy in the class with the shortest heifer, Mr. Jaxon. Good job, kids. We're proud of you. Miranda de Bruin, Jaxon Burrus. Please come in the show ring at this time. Triston Boehning, Amanda de Bruin, Jaxon Burrus. Alright, in the dairy heifer divisions, we have Showmanship, we have Junior and Senior. And so we will start with the Junior winner. Again, the shortest one in the class, Mr. Jaxon Burrus, is your Junior Showmanship winner. Your Senior Showmanship, the Showmanship winner for the seniors is Mr. Triston Boehning. And your overall winner, also Triston Boehning. Good job, guys. These kids deserve a round of applause. They did well. Also, we don't mean to leave the women out. Miranda, you did a really wonderful job showing. I need exhibitor 216 out of class 202, Ashton Hunt. I need exhibitor 212, Dagen Dunham. And I need exhibitor 215, Connor Harrison.
Yeah, there's a couple of things there. Celebrate that fact. I've thoroughly enjoyed getting to sort the cattle, and your young people to work with could not have better manners or sportsmanship, and your ring help was certainly knowledgeable, and it just made it all work. The quality of cattle, I wasn't concerned about coming here. Like I said, I've known this county to haul good cattle forever, and I know as counties seem to do, we fluctuate numbers over the years of how many show up, but one thing that's I know always been consistent here is the quality. And when I agreed to do this the other day, I knew it would be a little intimidating. There's standing ringside, more than half a dozen guys that can remember when I was showing. And I won't tell you how old I am, because that might embarrass them about how old they are. But I know they've been in the cow business a whole lot longer, had a whole lot more experience than me, and probably would do some things different. If I was going to be completely honest, we could bring this set of cattle back in 2 weeks to me, and I might do it different. If we sheared all these cattle off and brought them back slick sheared, I might do them different. And the point being is, no matter where you place today, and don't get me wrong, nobody likes to win more than me. But the other thing you need to get out of this did you and your calf have a good experience? Because you're fixing to get ready for major shows that are the most important. And hopefully you gain something, both in knowledge and preparation, and be successful in that endeavor. And all exhibitors, not just you three out here, but the ones back in the barn too, I'm going to ask you to do something for me. I want you to find your mom, your dad, your brother, your sister, your ag teacher, your county agent, whoever it is that really, really helps you with this stuff, because it doesn't just happen. Lives seem like they're so busy, we nearly have to have somebody help us. And we certainly can't be good at anything we started as a beginner if somebody doesn't guide us along the way. And I just want you to find one of those, whoever it is the dearest to you, and if it's multiple people, so be it. And sincerely tell them thank you. Because whether you know it or not, it's an awesome deal for you to be involved in this program. I'm probably biased, but nothing raises better young people than being involved in a show program. And I'm glad your parents or your agents or actors, whoever steered you toward doing this, I'm glad they did, and you're going to be a better person for it. The other thing, if you're disappointed how I placed this, I told you you couldn't tell my wife about the Herberts. You were probably anticipating Mr. Jones getting to sort the cattle here. And he'd be one of those people I would remember me showing and has more experience and knowledge about the cattle business. And I'm sure he would have done a few things different, and for some of you it would have been better. And so for what I lack on experience and knowledge, hopefully you'd agree that I make up, at least I'm better to look at than he is. So you can share that with him. But we've struggled through it, because of the quality of cattle. And I'm excited to get to go pick a champion. I'll just say as a group, I think all three of these lined up out here have an attractiveness to them, a showing presence to them, their level and their design. They can move as good as any of their contemporaries, probably in class of this quality. In all honesty, I wish the Shorthorn didn't stand quite astray on his hock on the stand. I wish the American didn't quite do that either. But when you move them, their range of motion is good. I don't see any limiting factors getting them to their end point. And you couple that with all the other good things those bring to the table, and that's why they won the breeds they did. They're probably a little more attractive in their design and strikingness than our exotic. But like I've gone back and forth describing him, what he lacks in flash, just substance, practicality, and good kind of cattle. There's just, it's hard to pick a major hole in him that you fault him for. And I certainly appreciate that about him. Well, again, thank you for having me, and y'all did me that favor, and go thank at least one person, if not multiple ones, for helping you get here, because it is important. And I believe that with my sincere heart. Thank you. Completely. I think it warrants the quality of these three cattle sitting here for reserve champion to just again express how deep I thought this show was and how high quality I think they are. And then when we bring our reserve exotic in, for me, this decision gets pretty close. I don't know about y'all ringside, but it does get really close for me. I'm going to go out and select a reserve grand and again wish all you exhibitors best of luck down the road.
Goes to exhibitor 217, Haley Hunt. Good job, kids. Ramage, Dagen Dunham in the ring, please. Rowdy Ramage, Dagen Dunham in the arena at this time, please. Come over here, Rowdy. Come over here. Stop right there. Whoa. Back up two steps. I said back up, not step up. All right, and showmanship for stairs in the junior division. And he was also nearly the shortest boy in the class, is Rowdy Ramage. Your senior division winner, and I promise you he wasn't the shortest one in the class, Dagen Dunham. Congratulations, guys. Heck of a job. All right, now you can back up, Rowdy. Thanks, guys. We appreciate it. Oh, excuse me. Dagen, come back. Overall, showman, senior, winner, Dagen Dunham. I was going to keep that buckle, Dagen. They caught.
Okay, now we get down into My second and third place are these two Californians. They're very close in type. They both exhibit a lot of the qualities you want in the rabbit breed. We do have the ladies in the blue. That rabbit's a little longer in the shoulder when you look at it when you've got him set up. Ladies in the red gave us a little hard time, but we finally got him. The young ladies in the leopard print, I talked to her about this rabbit. One of the worst things in rabbits is a genetic trait called malocclusion. Rabbits' teeth grow throughout their life, and they have to meet properly to file off. This rabbit's teeth are not correct. They are already starting to grow into each other. He has malocclusion. I couldn't actually place him. I had to place him last. In the rabbit show, that is actually a disqualification, and she would be asked to leave. Now, my two little Dutch here, they're cute. I can't say they're not cute. They're nice little Dutch. As far as going back into a breeding herd, they would be fine. Today in the show ring, both of them have color on their back feet that split their back toes. That is a severe fault in Dutch. So you have to know your markings in your Dutch. So that is what kept them from placing any higher in their class, because again, we're not actually judging rabbit against rabbit. Because we have a variety of breeds, we're judging rabbit against the breed standard. So my placing today is, again, the Californian first, and this young lady's is your second place. Thank y'all for having me.
At this time, we need exhibitor numbers 120, Peyton Hart, tag number 178. Exhibitor number 104, Doc Gardner, tag number 920. Exhibitor number 119, Caitlin Hart, tag number 177. Exhibitor 221, Logan Meiwes. And exhibitor 204, Braden Bessire, to the ring, please. To work with these young people and start doing your sheep show here in Bailey County. Before I name a champion in reserve, let's give all the youngsters that showed today a round of applause. We've got a really, really good group of lambs and a great group of kids out here in the middle of the ring. I think, when we looked at the the South Downs and the Fine Wool Cross. We didn't have many numbers in those particular classes, but I tell you, we've got some quality there. Each of those individuals have a lot of good things to offer each of their breeds. Went into the medium wool division. We had just a few more numbers, and those guys in this particular drive, you know, they surfaced to the top in their particular medium wool division, these two individuals out here. I think when we get to looking at these guys and try to find some sheep that meet our industry in terms of muscle and then balance and finish and design and structural correctness, I think there's a couple out here that do that rather easily for me today. And to name your champion and the reserve champion, Lamb of the Bailey County Stock Show. And so with that, I won't talk about it anymore. I know you guys have a lot of things to do, and you're going to have a hog show here in just a few minutes, so I won't take much more of your time. But I tell you what, there's a couple of individuals out here that fit together real good for me. That's going to be your two medium wools, and they'll be your grand and your reserve grand champion. Exhibitor 204, Braden Bessire. Can we get one more round of applause for those guys? For Sheep Showmanship, and I need Doc Gardner and Braden Bessire to the ring, please. Our junior trophy winner is Doc Gardner, and our senior trophy winner is Braden Bessire, and the overall buckle winner is Braden Bessire. Congratulations, guys. To the ring, that is Jaxon Lee, tag number 201, Emily, tag number 195, Cassidy Cage, tag number 194, William Wasson, tag number 199, Doc Gardner, tag number 201, and Cassidy Cage, tag number 192. Please report to the ring at this time.
go some work with these young people. Before I select a champion in reserve, let's give all the folks that showed here a round of applause. It takes a lot of work to put a county show on. We just had ours last week, and I'm thankful that it's over and done with. And I know that it takes a lot of work to put those on, and then you guys have had the hardship of snow and sleet and ice and everything that you guys have had the last couple of days. So at this time, if you would, let's give your advisors, your ag teachers, your county agents, and then all of the show board and everybody that puts this show on a round of applause for a really, really nice show. I think when we talk about any type of market animal, you know, we talk about structure and muscle and balance, and we just have to try to find those that in our minds put those together to a higher degree. And I'm certainly pleased with the group of goats that we have out here that won and were first and second in each of their classes as we worked through this afternoon. And I think they've got some muscle, they've got some design, and they've got some balance and some stoutness of structure. And I think as I get to looking at this lineup, I think there's a couple of goats out here that hit me pretty hard in terms of muscle and stoutness and design. And I think they just bring to the table a little bit more in terms of that. I think they're really stout-maned, thick-maned goats, and they're pretty enough to look at from the side when we get to looking at them. And I think they'll do very good if these young people were to try to take them and show them on down the road at another major stock show if they choose to do so. But at this time, without any further ado, I'll go ahead and go out and I'll name your champion and your reserve champion, Market Goat.
Champion Exhibitor 208, Cassidy Cage, and our Reserve Grand Champion Exhibitor 104, Doc Gardner. Let's give them one more round of applause. Doc Gardner and Cassidy Cage to the ring, please. Doc Gardner and Cassidy Cage to the ring. Showmanship goes to Doc Gardner, and our senior trophy winner goes to Cassidy Cage. Let's give them a round of applause, and Cassidy was our overall buckle winner. Exhibitor 213, Kinley, Dunham. Exhibitor 218, Jacob Kettner. Exhibitor 229, Joseph Rahino. Exhibitor 103, Colby Daniel. exhibitor 218, Jacob Kettner. Exhibitor 226, Kayla Preston. Exhibitor 233, Joe Wagner. Exhibitor 202, Zoe Apodaca. And Exhibitor 217, Haley Hunt. And Exhibitor 218, Jacob Kettner. Coming into the ring is the champion Chester, Exhibitor 229, Joseph Romino. Entering the ring, Exhibitor 103, champion Durham, Kobe Daniel. Entering the ring, Exhibitor 226, champion Hampshire, Kayla Preston. Entering the ring, champion Spot, Exhibitor 233, Joe Wagner. Entering the ring, champion York, Exhibitor 202, Zoe Apodaca. And entering the ring, champion Cross, Exhibitor 217, Haley Hunt. All reserve breeds into the holding pen. All reserves into the holding pen. That would be Exhibitor 217, Haley Hunt. Exhibitor 108, Riley Kettner. Exhibitor 117, Haley Thomas. Exhibitor 218, Jacob Kettner. Exhibitor 234, William Wasson. Exhibitor 206, Alina Kadina. And Exhibitor 226, Kayla Preston. All reserves, please report to the holding pen at this time.
Here we are at the end of the day. This is what it's all about. Grand Champion, the county show. There's only one of these every year. It's going to be a reserve grand later. It's always an exciting time for every youngster. I think the show's big. That's one of their goals. They buy those pigs in the fall and they put them on feed. Their advisor, their dad, or granddad, Aunt Lucille, or whoever it is. That's a dream that they want to try to touch on their way to a major in most instances. There's one of them out here that I really think sums it all up for me. Overall balance and design. The one that I'd most like to throw in the pickup and carry home with me. That's the one I'm going to make a grand champion. I've enjoyed being here. I apologize to my boys. I know it's got to be a pitiful deal having to listen to me talk like this, but it might have been better for you that way. I'm not talking to you. So without further ado, I'm going to go select our grand champion there on 2015 Baby Cash Show.
this time, I need Jacob Kettner, exhibitor 218, with the reserve Hampshire into the ring at this time. Livestock Show Grand Champion, Kayla Preston, exhibitor 226, and your reserve Grand Champion, exhibitor 217, Haley Hunt. Let's give them a big round of applause. Riley Kettner and Kayla Preston to the ring, please. Swine Showmanship, our junior trophy winner is Riley Kettner. Our senior trophy winner, Miss Kayla Preston. And our overall buckle winner is Kayla Preston as well. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Texas flag down. 25, now 30, we'll get 30, 30, 30, 25, now 30, 30, 25, we'll get 30 here, 5. 30, now 5, 5, we'll get 35, 5, 35, 35, 30, we'll get 5, 5, 35, all turned down, so we'll be right there. 5, 40, 40, 40, 35, we'll get 40. 40, 40, 40, so we'll be right, 35. Gary Boehning. He don't trust y'all, he's coming to get the thing. Andy's Clippers, donated by Muleshoe Vet Supply. Andy's Clippers. Seen some of them didn't look like they clip very good. It's time for y'all to get the entire Clippers. Right here, you can get it today. Hey, Chief Pat, I need to talk to you right quick. 50, now 5, on the Clippers, 55, are you bidding Julie, 55, oh, Julie Cage, she wants those Clippers, 55, 50, now 5, 55, when you get 55, 55, 55, 55, 55, 55, 55, 55, 60, you're out, Julie, 60, JD needs a haircut too, 60, 55, now 60, your daughter-in-law's on her knees with a pair of scissors yesterday, done, 65, 65, sell me away, $60. Kirk Miller, he needs a haircut too. Boys are gonna sell a John Deere tractor and wagon right here. Donated by Gallman Equipment. $25,000. I mean $25 now. $30, $25, we get $30. It's just a toy. $25, $35, $35, $5. All you kids can bid here. $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, $35, 40, Betty Kirby, you got it, 40, 50, 60, 70, so we weigh $60. Betty Kirby. Is that what kind you drive, Betty? Is that what kind you drive, John Deere? You betcha. Alright, Ruby Green's baby boy businessman bib. There we go. Handyman bib. Oh, it's a girl? Well, it's a baby boy one. Baby boy bib right here. 25, now 30. If you want everybody town know that you've got a baby boy instead of a baby girl, you might want to buy this. 25, now 30, 25, 15, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20,
Kettner.
Thank you, Kirby, for all your service. Hey, come around here and let Madison take a picture of you, if you would, please. Or you and Michael.
If I may, I'd like to recognize somebody. Many of y'all remember or know J.K. Adams. He was a longtime county agent here in Bailey County. And we lost him a couple of months ago. And just like, I know some of y'all may be too young not to know J.K., but J.K. started here in 1942. He told me many stories through the years. He got out of the Navy and wore his naval uniform when he went and met the Commissioner's Court to be hired here. was here for 30 years and then retired. And he was real funny. He never stopped being a county agent. He'd been retired 17 years when I moved here and was always coming to me and telling me what they used to do. And, J.K. loved hogs, in Poland especially. And after he retired, many people didn't know he served as a swine superintendent at Fort Worth Stock Show for many years and really loved doing that. And during the 60s and early 70s, J.K. was also real instrumental in doing a lot of fertility work. We had, back then, he said there were soil scientists telling him we didn't need to fertilize with our soil up here. And he did a lot of work through that. Anyway, I'd just like to recognize J.K. And his wife, Margaret. And if y'all would, let's give him a hand.
Livestock Park. First thing we're going to sell is the 2014 Grand Champion Steer at Beatty County Junior Livestock Show, shown by Connor Harrison. Let's give him a hand. Connor Harrison, Grand Champion Steer. Okay, boys, right here now. Grand Champion Steer, Connor Harrison. Buyers Club, 2,300 for the Grand Champion Steer. Grand Champion Dairy Heifer, shown by Triston Boehning. Triston Boehning, give him a hand, folks. Grand Champion Dairy Heifer, right here. And Triston was also the senior dairy showmanship winner yesterday. Senior showmanship winner. 2,800. Going once, twice, 2,800. Some your way, 2,700. J&S Dairy, J&S Dairy right there. Thank you, Flores. Grand Champion Barra was shown by Kayla Preston. She was also the senior swine showmanship winner, and she was also awarded this morning the Jimmy Dale Black Showmanship Award. And she's a senior. He's one of the few that got it all right her last year. So good job, Kayla, on all your awards right here. $2,700. 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, Corvette Farm. James Brown, Corvette Farm. Bought a send-off for our senior right there. Our grand champion lamb, shown by Logan Meiwes. No, it's not. He is a senior. Logan's a senior. This will be his last show right here with his grand champion lamb. One in a line of many that he had. And won the showmanship several years right here. Logan Meiwes with the grand champion lamb. 1,000 now 1,100. 10 when you get 11. 1,100 now 1,100. 1,100 now 1,200. 11 now 12, 13, 1,400, 1,500, 1,600, 1,700, 1,800, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1,900, 1 1700, 1700, 1700, 1800, 1800, 1800, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, 1900, some your way, 1800. Jeff Boehning, Jeff Boehning. Now we have our grand champion goat, shown by Cassidy Cage. She was also selected as the senior goat showmanship winner yesterday. So give her a hand for that. Grand champion goat. All right, sir. Here, 10 hundred now. 11 hundred. 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, 3200, of the 3,200, number one woman, all through and down to your 3,200, all through and done. And sold your way, 3,100. Muleshoe Bet Supply, Muleshoe Bet Supply.